Okay, I'm going to take a little extra care, caution. And my husband was looking on the website and he goes, "Hi, you get to play with the bats." I said, "Bats and rats, not a problem."
Yeah.
So long as there's no spiders, we're cool.
Oh yeah, I don't like spiders. I don't like spiders or snakes.
I'll take care of the snakes, you take care of the spiders.
We probably will see a few bats, but they're really small.
Uh-huh.
They're called tricolored bats.
Uh-huh.
They're really cute. Sometimes when they're flying around, of course they look a lot bigger with their wingspan and everything, but they still aren't super really scary.
Yeah. I have no problem with most animals at all.
Okay, so this is our first room. It's also the largest. Throughout the cave, you're going to see four different types of formations. So we can hand it out to you. This first one is a stalactite. We call it that because it hangs tight to the ceiling. The second one is a stalagmite. It's close to the ground, so you might trip over it. When these two grow together, they form this, is what we call a column. This is our largest column. It's over 70 feet tall and 40 feet around and a new big Goliath. So the last one is over there behind you. That's drapery. It's a type of stalactite. It's an in the wall instead of the ceiling. We're going to see this in pretty much every room that we go in.
I would truly love to have been the first people in here.
Mm-hmm. I bet they have. The first people, the people that came in here and installed all the handrails and all the stairs were the Boy Scouts in the early 60s, late 50s, early 60s. It was our Boy Scout leader's idea to open up the cave to the public.
Uh-huh.
So he got his Boy Scout troop to come in here. So they got paid about $1 a day when they first started in here, and then when they started giving tours and they were still working on it a little bit, they got paid up to $3 a day.
Wow.
All right, that was really cool of them making out $1 a day. So we call this our Brothel Room because on July 12th, 1958, a couple stood in front of this room and typed stalactite, and they said their vows and they got married here.
Ah, that'd be cool.
Mm-hmm. It was the first underground wedding recorded in Alabama. You can also get married in here today for $300. We can promise you a great venue and no ring.
That's all right.
This right here is our first whirlpool column. The way this whole cave was formed, it was all once underwater. Water was actually stuck flowing through here. And then to this next one. So this was our second one right here. There's three total. These are our first two.
Sorry, I was looking down the hole.
Oh, it's okay.
That just looked too cool.
I call those our creepy maintenance stairs right there.
Creepy maintenance?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Now, I'm one of these people, I take off looking at places.
That's okay, I won't leave you. There's a lot of places you can hit your head in this hallway, so be careful.
Earlier today, I took off walking over to the left side over there.
Mm-hmm.
Only I was running out of time, so I had to come back. I love to walk.
Yes, I like walking on the hiking trail.
So long as it's not too rainy.
Mm-hmm. One of the hiking trails is the Fossil Mountain Trail. It's super rocky.
Uh-huh.
So right now it's probably really slick.
Oh, it is. I took the puppies with me,
mm-hmm.
and they were having a blast. New smells. This is neat.
This through here actually used to be a cool reef. So you can tell the rock is different than the limestone.
Uh-huh.
It's really chalky.
Sounds different walking on it.
So if you notice that sign when we first walked in that said fallout shelter,
uh-huh.
that was because in the early 60s, the government declared this was suitable to be a fallout shelter.
Uh-huh.
So back through this hallway, it's really far back there. I stored about 9 tons of food,
uh-huh.
and I should feed 3,000 people for 14 days.
Wow.
But they later found out the cave's capacity was only 1,100 people, so I could feed them a little longer than that.
All right.
There's still about, I think, 2 tons left back there.
Wow.
We don't go back there because there's a lot of broken glass on the floor and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
And the barrels or metal drums that they were kept in, they're rusted right now. So you don't want you to get cut on those.
That would be bad.
Mm-hmm. There's a picture of what's back there at the very end.
Okay.
And then the actual bottles of medicine that are back there. And in the gift shop, we have some other stuff that we found. We found a lot of Coke cans and stuff like that.
That would be cool.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the old Coke cans are rather neat.
Mm-hmm. They had like a different type of lid.
Uh-huh. Any of the old cork kind or?
I don't know how to explain it. It's like, it had like the long skinny top that you kind of popped off, I think.
Oh, okay.
That was really cool though.
Do this my way. Okay. It just looks neat up there. I'm going to forget which direction this is facing and take a selfie. There you go.
It's weird because sometimes I have just the other day I had 35 people on one of my tours.
Oh, that would be a snake.
Yeah. And then I think I like one person tour better, one person tour second. Because
uh-huh.
I don't have to yell as loud and all that. When I have 35 people, I have to yell so loud because they're all the way.
I'd lose my voice.
Mm-hmm.
I can yell about 3 times and then my voice is gone.
Yeah. I had a group of Boy Scouts that came in here. So they were really excited to be in here.
Oh boy. The rock's changing again.
Right now it's limestone. Yeah. It's all limestone, but.
Yeah, it's getting glittery again.
It looks different from parts of the cave. Some of the glitter is quartz in the rocks.
Mm-hmm. I take
awesome.
Rocks and carve them into little statues.
Mm-hmm.
One of the main reasons we came here,
mm-hmm.
to see what kind of rocks. Ooh, this looks neat. Just the way it breaks up and you can look through it.
So we actually call this room the Badlands, because if you look out, it kind of looks like the Badlands of South Dakota, if you've ever seen those.
Oh yeah. We have that on our list,
mm-hmm.
to go there, just to go look and walk.
Also, if you hear that humming noise,
uh-huh.
that's our electromagnetic box hidden over there behind the rocks.
Uh-huh.
So you can see the wires coming out of that.
Uh-huh.
They go up that hole about 125 feet to the surface.
All right.
So we are not 125 feet down right now. It's not the deepest point we're going to get to. The deepest point is 175 feet.
Uh-huh.
Also, if you notice from our Pepsi thermometer, which it doesn't really work anymore, it's been there since about the 70s, and we are a Coke company now. If it did work, it would say it stays about 61 to 62 degrees in here year-round,
uh-huh.
no matter how hot or cold it is outside.
That'd be nice.
Mm-hmm. So in the summertime when you come in here, it feels a lot cooler when it's 90 to 100 degrees in the summertime.
Mm-hmm.
And then in the winter when it's 20 degrees, it feels a lot warmer in here, so it's pretty nice. That is a little bit warmer than other natural cave temperatures, because the old lights we used to have in here, they were flood lights. They put off a lot of heat. So throughout the years of them being in here, They call the cake, they call the chimchurga cherry crisps. They also cause green stuff to grow on the rocks or the more active parts of the cave are, because the moisture with that heat caused that to grow. I'll show you that.
Okay.
Since then we have replaced the lights with LED lights. They don't go off the computer or anything, so.
I love the way these rocks are. The way they just look so tumbled and everything. Mm-hmm.
Stand at the top. If you both jump off and you both survive, you'll be together forever. If only one of you survives, the one that does survive will never find love again.
Oh, that's sad.
So it's not a very good story.
No. I think I'll not jump.
Yeah. We've never had anyone actually jump off of there, though, so.
We'll not try that. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then right here is our rock wall. All this is the debris from the dynamite. At the Boy Scout season here. So they actually had a retired coal miner come in and teach them how to use that.
Mm-hmm.
Since the ceiling through here used to be only 2 to 3 feet tall, they wanted most people to be able to walk through here without having to worry about, you know, the ceiling being really low. So the rocks aren't concreted down or anything. I'm sorry, so don't pull on them. They got to worry about you though.
We'll leave them be.
Mm-hmm. We're gonna be on the other side of it in a minute. So we're gonna come back here and circle around, and then you'll see it again. Just in case you do decide to pull on the rocks, management has provided this prop rock.
Oh, goody. That's holding the roof up, huh?
Yes.
That is too cool. I like that. Just in case somebody is silly, huh?
Yeah.
That is too sweet.
This right here is our caveman drum.
Ooh.
Because if you punch on it, it really sounds like a drum.
Uh-huh.
You can punch on it too.
That is cool. I could get us sidetracked and we'll be here forever. Whoever walked inside of there had to have little bitty feet. There was little bitty. That looks neat.
So you sit down on the rock in here if you want to. This is where I'm going to turn off the lights and show you what complete and total button is. So there are 3 places you can find complete total darkness. Do you know where that is?
Let's see, caves would be one for sure.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The subway.
It's not wrong.
A basement with no windows. I can't think of any others.
Yeah, those are right. One time I had one lady with like coughing, and I was like,
oh. I haven't tried that. Don't want to.
Yeah, no.
That's the only ones I can think of.
So there's at the bottom of the ocean, outer space, and then a cave.
Outer space would have stars.
Mm-hmm. And a black hole in outer space.
Okay, here you go.
Or did you just say outer space?
Yeah, that would work. Mm-hmm. But now we're in total darkness.
So you probably noticed it's so dark you can put your hand right in front of your face and with your finger. Okay, you can see that.
Uh-huh. Ha ha ha. This would mess with my sister.
Yes. So we call this the diamond room. You can see it a little bit. The ceiling sparkles like diamonds. It's actually just calcite and quartz in the rocks.
Yep. Actually, when I'm walking the dogs at night with a, I very seldom use a flashlight. But if I'm walking across strange rocks and I want to see something, I'll turn on my flashlight, and that's how I find some very special rocks, because they'll shine.
Yeah. It's not, I don't think it's really cool when you
shine. I like that.
It's really quiet in here. No sparking or anything. So it's also said if you stay in complete darkness, like this, for more than 2 weeks, you go irreversibly blonde.
You're kidding.
No, no. More than a night, your hair could turn white. And ooh, longer than that, you go insane.
Let's not do that.
Yeah. I always turn the lights back on after I say that.
I have never tried that. Although my hair is trying to turn white, we will not.
You can look around back here if you want to.
Yes.
It's just a dead end. It doesn't go anywhere.
I'm always in for looking about. Now give me the opportunity. Ooh, okay. Interesting.
So back here to the left is our third whirlpool column.
I saw that interesting looking stuff.
And then back here is like mainly the reason they call it the diamond room. So the ceiling sparkles a lot more back here. You can even see
ooh,
the lights.
Check that out.
You can even see what the light's on. This is the part where, well, if I have little kids, I'm not sure where they like to run around and play and stuff, because it doesn't go there. Kind of get in back here.
They can safely roam without getting lost.
I'm going to get it all out before we get to the next part, because on the next part, they can't really run or anything because there's stairs and stuff.
I know what my husband's going to be doing for the rest of the day.
Do you guys like to travel a lot?
Well, we just got our RV about 2 months ago. So we're, you know, traveling, letting him see the world.
I know my mom really wants a camper. She thinks they're so cute. I think she said when we move out that she's going to get one and they're going to travel.
Well, we're both retired military, and we both, cool, check that out. Yeah, we both traveled a lot, you know, before he was disabled, and now we want to travel some more. Excuse me. And now we're off to see all our old military friends and all our family.
That's fun.
Yep.
My sister's boyfriend is actually in the Marines.
Oh, cool.
He just got, I don't really know how it works. She knows every little part of it because she keeps up with it, but he was in, is it like North Carolina? He just got stationed in California.
Okay.
But he thinks Japan, but he's right down the
border. I was born and raised in Northern California. And
it seems really cool. I want to go to California.
Well, it's beautiful, but expensive.
Yeah, I've heard it's really expensive.
And very expensive. And they have some of the craziest fruit and nut rules you've ever heard of. You know, you can't drive a car unless it has all kinds of inspections. It has to have smog inspections and safety inspections, and they can pull you over at any time for an inspection.
Oh.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yep, and when you pull into the state, they will ask you in Spanish if you have any illegal aliens. Don't answer in Spanish.
Oh. I didn't know that. They do that.
They do. For God's sakes, do not answer in Spanish. Go, huh?
What? No. Just,
what? What did you say?
No.
Just act stupid.
Yeah.
Don't even go, no, don't speak any, just go, huh?
Yeah.
And they'll pass you by. Yeah.
That's funny.
It's no joke. Just, huh?
So this hallway actually is the bottom of those curvy magnet stairs I showed you earlier.
Uh-huh.
So if someone wanted to get out of the cave faster, we could just go up those and go back to the entrance.
Okay. I'm all in for more walk.
Yeah.
Ooh. Little bitty stalagmite things.
Stalagmites, yeah.
Them things.
So be careful up here. This is usually a spot where like everybody
slides down in the...
Yeah, flips a little bit.
Yeah. And most of my immediate family is still in California.
Mm-hmm. All of my family lives here, so. I thought it'd be really cool to have like family that lives in different states and stuff, so you can go visit them. But.
Well, I've got family in Louisiana. My dad's from Louisiana. My mom's from California. So I can. I visit them all over.
Mm-hmm.
And then I've got more family in Utah. And then my husband's family is from Georgia and Florida. So
they're kind of from everywhere.
Yeah, and then we've got military friends everywhere. So when we go visit him, we can find friends, family, outlaws.
Yeah. Just having everyone everywhere.
But it's fun. We went to Las Vegas to visit our son.
Oh, my friend's from Las Vegas. Natural bridge. So we're going to see two others and I'll point them out when we walk under them. But this one we actually people come in and test to see how much weight it can hold. So the way they tested it, they put as much weight on it as they could until it started to crumble. And then after that it kind of not really broke it, but it can't hold quite that much anymore. They got about 1,500 pounds on it.
I wouldn't want to do that just because I wouldn't want to break it.
Mm-hmm. So it did crumble. It probably can't hold 1,500 pounds anymore, but it could at one point. I thought it was a joke when they told me that. I was like, how did they get all that weight down here and put it on top of there? And I don't know, but they really did that. It took me a while to believe it.
It'd be one of those where, you know, in our day and age of preserving stuff, we wouldn't even do it.
That is the main of iron ore, the natural bridge that I showed you. So I guess they were just curious. And then this is our seven natural stairs.
That's kind of cool.
Mm-hmm. So the light's out at the bottom, but when the cave floods, it has to be like super flooded for water to flow down the bottom of these. But most of the time when it floods, it just sits. So it hasn't flooded at all, but you can kind of see where water usually just sits right there. And then this is our second natural bridge, so it hangs really low. Just watch your head when you walk under it.
It's almost too bad we haven't seen a bat yet.
we rarely see them before the elevator shaft door.
Uh-huh.
So That big hole from the beginning, there's like a black door.
Uh-huh.
And in that room, there's usually a lot of bats.
That'd be cool to mess with Bill. Say, look, here's one right here. This close apart.
And then we call this our concrete room because it kind of looks like concrete. There's actually pieces of the ocean floor that suck up and fossilized over time.
Huh.
So you can tell a big difference in that in the natural cave ceiling. The natural cave ceiling is super flat.
Uh-huh.
So I think that's pretty cool.
Uh-huh. Too many things to look at one time.
Oh yeah, if not, I need to slow down. I can't. I've been in here so many times. But it's pretty cool. Every time I come in here, I see something different.
Uh huh.
But just let me know if you want me to walk slower and things to come up around. And then this is our man-made bridge right here. You can see what's kind of underneath it. I didn't want people to have to walk over that or anything.
Yeah, mud flow. Yeah, we'll pass. Ooh, that's a cool one up there. Neat. Ooh.
And then we call this the King's Room. So it has the biggest and best piece of the jackfruit in all of our cakes, so we say it's fit for a king.
Oh.
This first piece right here is our largest. It goes all the way up there from the ceiling, all the way down to the floor. And then the second piece you probably saw when you're walking over the stairs. Kind of looks like it's glowing.
Uh-huh.
That is transparent drapery.
Mm-hmm.
Also, it's so thin, if you put a light between it, you can see the light actually shining through it. We also call that cake bacon. Because it kind of looks like bacon from the side.
It does.
Mm-hmm. I think it looks a lot like bacon. Usually a little bat hanging somewhere in here. Most of the time they'll hang somewhere for like, usually about 2 to 3 weeks. And then they'll move. And this right here is our third natural bridge. And then this we call our elephant room.
There you go.
We aren't really sure why.
Could be him.
Yeah, that's what I thought before. The original plans for this, I wouldn't tell you, Mr. Eddie Rickles was a Boy Scout leader's name.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. R. Wood was the main one that financed everything that went on in here. So they combined their names to make Rickwood. So That's where that comes from. Mr. Rickles had originally planned to make this into a cafe. So you can tell from the steps that come up that cafe stairs. But he wanted to sell hot dogs and coffee in here. Stuff like that, but that never happened. Though I think that would be pretty cool if we were selling hot dogs and coffee.
I'd go for the coffee.
Yeah, I don't want a hot dog, but at least coffee.
Coffee would be really good.
And then there's a bat hanging. There's two bat traps that hang right
I see
here.
Those two.
See another one right up there.
There's a little bat. He's cute.
We're only going to see one that's closer than that, so you can...
There's a little bat. Bill was trying to mess with me. He's like, you're going to see bats. I was like, bats and rats, they're all cool. I used to have a baby rat. Mm-hmm. Or actually, he wasn't baby. He was like almost this long.
Oh, no.
As a pet.
I like little ones. So I call us right here Fat Man Squeeze.
And I was really inventive with his name. Mm-hmm. I called him Ben.
I wouldn't mind like little baby. I guess not like. I wouldn't mind a mouse.
They're really intelligent and gentle, unless you get mean with them or anything.
Mm-hmm. This is another bat right there.
There we go.
Trying to shine a light directly on it.
He's a cute little guy.
And then there's a
bunny
right here.
Oh, he'll come up close and say hello without scaring him. Yeah, we're not going to scare the little guy.
Yeah, and then there's a lot in this room. So there's one right here.
Yep, lots of little bats. There's one. See if we can get a face view.
There's one right here, there's one right there, there's two right there.
Mm-hmm. There we go. We're not going to scare the little guys, though.
When they start moving, they're putting a lot of them.
Yeah.
They can fly, so that one
right
there.
Yep.
Maybe he won't start flying. Because...
Oh, he's a cute little one.
Mm-hmm. And there's one right there. One right here.
Mm-hmm.
There's two right there.
They are so tiny.
They're kind of all over this room. Mm-hmm. I think they're super cute.
Uh-huh. They are adorable.
And then this right here is our elevator shaft door. So okay. If you were to move that door and walk down a hallway about 40 feet, you would be looking up where we're looking down earlier.
Mm-hmm.
This would have been the end of your tour. That would have been finished. Lucky for you, we get to walk up 309 stairs at the very end.
All right.
But we also get to see the last 25% of the cave. So this is said to be the most beautiful part that's still active and growing. Active and growing also means there's going to be some formation dripping. There's going to be more water. Please don't touch the formations that you see that are dripping. Your hands have oils on them that can create a film over the rocks and prevent water from flowing through them and prevent them from growing. In this room we're walking into is the queen's room. Since every king does have a queen. Now these two things I'm going to point out don't have anything to do with the queen. I just like them, so. This one is our upside down city of New York.
Oh, cool.
There's also a little bat up there. You see that door? He looks like a stalactite.
He's hiding.
Yes. And then this one right here, have you seen the Grinch?
Yes.
I think everybody's seen the Grinch. I call that Mount Crumpet, the mountain that he lives in. There is a small puddle at the top of these stairs. We call this Bat Lady Squeeze. It's also a little bit more muddy through here. So just be careful.
Frodo has been through here. Have you ever read any of Frodo's books?
I haven't.
Any of The Hobbit?
I started to read one, but I forgot friend wanted to borrow it, so I gave it to her and she never gave it back.
You're missing something.
I heard they're really good. I feel like I would really like those books and Harry Potter.
Yeah.
So I'm trying to wait to read them, because once I read a book, I don't really reread it again.
I know what you mean, because I remember word for word every book I ever read.
Once I get a book, I don't, you know, so I want to wait to read all the Harry Potter. I read the first one and I loved it. I just wanted to buy all of them, but...
I've read all the Harry Potters, all of the Frodo books. I was like, wow. And this would so be there.
I watched one of the Hobbit movies, but I think it was the very first one. I really liked it. And I wanted to just watch all of them, and I was like, I'm going to wait to watch them all. Because I don't really watch movies a lot either. So right here are our 13 unlucky stairs. These are pretty steep and slippery, so just be careful walking down them.
Okay.
This first part of the handle right here is a little wiggly.
Okay.
But the rest of it's fine, so don't worry.
You know I have to stop and take pictures of that side scene there.
Yeah.
It looks kind of neat.
This part here is probably my favorite. There's so many information for it and all that. It's kind of cool. And then these stairs don't have handrails, so you can grab onto the rocks if you need to. This is what happens when a lot of people touch the rocks. They kind of look, start looking shiny and from the oil on their hands.
They stop doing what they're doing.
The green stuff I told you about in the very beginning.
Uh-huh.
It's mainly around each light. So if you look at a light and then look around it, you'll see it. The ceiling also gets a little bit lower, and then there's a puddle.
Okay.
Right where it gets lower.
So okay.
It's a really bad spot for that. And then you can see it from the back.
There we go.
You can see it all.
Oh, we got a garden going.
And then this is like the main part of it then.
We were just up there.
And then this, we call that way up there a fossilized tree, because it kind of looks like a tree. And then right here are our 30 steepest stairs.
Okay.
These look really scary, but they're actually not too bad. I've had more people fall on the other ones than these.
Okay.
So if that makes you feel any better, watch your head when you're walking onto the stairs.
Okay.
I like to walk down them sideways because they're super small. They get really small. And then if you want to stop and look around, you can. I think we need some lights up there. That looks really pretty.
That'd be beautiful. This is just one of those, take your time, do it right.
Really slow, because one time I was just not really being as careful because I was like, I now I know how to walk down these, and I slipped down a few.
Oh no, that's what you don't want to do.
I've fallen so many times though.
And even when you're young, falling down is not a good thing. Almost have a dragon's nest in there.
We actually call this our whale's mouth right here. Because it looks like you're looking at the inside of a whale.
There's tonsils back there.
Yeah. Right here's the uvula. And there's the backbone. Mm-hmm. And right here's his tongue.
Uh-huh. That works.
It can also be seen as a bathroom. Either way, so right here is the sink.
Uh-huh.
There is the soap.
Mm-hmm.
Soap holder. And then there's water. Can you see the water back there?
Too short.
Yeah, I can. Can't really see it. But there's water right there, and we call that our bathtub.
Okay. Maybe but, I got it on film.
Yeah, it's really hard to see. I've come back down one time. That's the only reason I know there's for sure water back there.
Tell you what, whoever did all this work took some time.
Yes.
Couldn't even imagine getting paid $1 an hour or $1 a day, whichever it was.
Yeah, it's $1 a day, which is crazy.
Really? $1 a day.
Mm-hmm. But the Boy Scouts were, I think, like 9 to 18-year-old boys.
Yeah. I used to, when I was a teenager, I worked as a cook and trail guide at a Girl Scout camp.
Mm-hmm.
Now that was back in the early 60s, early 70s. Ooh, that is clear water. Oh, and there's fish.
Mm-hmm. Not sure what. The cavefish or albino, they don't have any eyes, but they do get in from, you know, the rivers and lakes and stuff, so that's what that one is. It's cool to see stuff in here, because you hardly ever do.
Well, I got him on film for just a split second.
Mm-hmm. Maybe we can see a crawfish. They look like little tiny white dots, and they're pretty hard to see.
There's something there in your light. Mm-hmm. If he moves, doubt it.
I think that is one.
Uh-huh. He's not gonna move.
Mm-hmm. they're better when they're like closer up here.
Mm-hmm.
They're a lot easier to look at. So there are cavefish and crawfish in here.
Mm-hmm.
I've never seen a cavefish, but I've seen a lot of crawfish. I think that's one too. They just look like little white dots.
Mm-hmm.
Do you see the half of a square white pipe right there?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I say it's white. That is 8 feet under the water.
Wow.
That was moving.
Yep, it's moving.
So it's pretty hard to tell that it's 8 feet under the water because the water is so clear.
It's moving. That's a crayfish.
Mm-hmm.
Ha! That is wild.
Mm-hmm. They do look really cool. One time there was like 3 or 4 here at one time.
Mm. He's definitely moving.
Yeah, maybe I'll come closer up here. Sometimes they're just really hard to see. But that right there is a water line, so that helps a little bit with the water and everything. One time, something got in. It was just like a normal crawfish, I think.
Mm-hmm.
And it was swimming around in here, and I didn't know other stuff could get in from rivers and lakes.
Mm-hmm.
But I thought I had like discovered something new. I was like, what is that? That's not supposed to be in here.
Mm-hmm.
And I got really excited, and I got out of the cave, and I told everybody. And they were like, yeah, stuff just gets in all the time.
Mm-hmm.
So we've had a few salamanders. Usually we have frogs around here, but haven't seen them in a while. This is also the main part that floods when the cave floods.
Mm-hmm.
So water actually comes out from underneath the whale's mouth, if you remember that.
Mm-hmm.
It flows down to here, and it like flows into this.
Mm-hmm.
And then also water pours into it from other, it's fed from an unknown source. They're not really sure where it comes from. Excuse me. But it rises up, and you can see like the water lines kind of from where it has been before. So it has gotten, usually it just floods to, you know, the floor, the handrail, but it has gotten really far up before. So of course we can't get paved floors when it does flood.
Yeah, that would be kind of a, well, sorry.
Mm-hmm. One time we came here and it was just starting to flood. There wasn't too much water, but there was a lot of puddles. Mm-hmm. And my shoes got soaking wet, and I was like, if you guys want to turn around, it's fine. You turn around, and they're like, no, no, we can go. And like my shoes up to my ankles.
Oh, man.
We're soaking wet, yeah.
That'd just be a bummer. Mm-hmm. Looks like water comes in from up there, too.
Yeah, so this is the main part where our bats hang out.
Uh-huh. So there's some there in there. Yep. Mm-hmm.
Also, when I finally see, every time I come in here, I look in here and I'm like, maybe I'll see a cavefish. Never seen one. A girl has been around here for about 10 years, off and on. She's seen one cavefish.
Mm.
So they're really pretty.
Maybe one day.
Yeah, well, maybe one day. I've had people come in and say, there used to be schools of those, like, swimming around in here. Lucky. I can see one.
Really? They're waiting for you to leave so they can come out.
Yeah. That's what they do every time I leave. They're like, I'm just going. So, this is the last room we're going to see in your cave tour. I hope you've enjoyed it. So, I'm going to walk behind you just to make sure you make it out okay. It's usually for bigger tours to make sure everybody gets out.
Okay.
This is the hallway you're going to walk through. Watch out for that pipe. It's really in the way. Don't have to worry about it.
Okay. I'm rather short, so.
Yeah.
Not a biggie.
We're probably going to see a lot of bats.
Yeah, they're not, I'm not worried about the bats.
There's two up here to the left, and I think those have been there for a while.
Yeah, they look pretty fat and happy.
Yes.
And there's three more up here.
Mm-hmm.
Rather cute little guys.
I like counting and seeing how many there are. One time I counted it, 23.
Wow.
Is this hallway?
I'm not as observant as you are.
When I first started living here, I couldn't, like the, when other tour guides would bring me in here that already worked here, they'd be like, oh, there's that. And I could never find any. Now I've gotten pretty good at spotting them. Because they blend in if you don't shine a light on them.
Uh-huh. Here's one here. He's kind of close.
Mm-hmm.
Little bitty guy.
I like when they're close so I can see them. Except when they pop their head up and start moving around, I get nervous.
Yep, there's one right there.
I usually don't see most of them through here because I'm usually looking at my feet.
Uh-huh.
And I have a hat on, so.
There's two more here. Little bitty guys. And a whole bunch more around the corner up here.
Yeah. There's a lot for here.
One right here.
I'm surprised.
Down under
Oh, wow. There's a lot in here.
Two right here.
Let's go on. Two, three, four, five, eight, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30.
Oh my word. You turn around and they're all over up there.
Yeah. Oh wow.
They are all over. That almost looks like wood.
That's pretty cool.
Mm-hmm.
I've never seen that many. There probably has been that many, I just might not have been paying attention. Oh, that one's really close here.
Hello, little one. Are you saying hello? I almost brushed him with my head. I'm glad I'm not afraid of critters.
Oh, yeah.
Could you imagine somebody that's afraid of bats?
I've had a lot of people that are terrified of
bats. Oh, no. That's just sad.
They're not even... No, I think they're a little cute. I don't think they're scary or anything.
They do a very good service for us.
Mm-hmm.
This is an interesting survey.
So this is the building that we were just in.
I see the decorations.
Yes.
Have connection. There we go. And
this is the picture that I showed you that was down the hallway.
All right.
There's some of the medicine.